Ladies and gentlemen, we have just arrived at London King's Cross. Will passengers please make sure that they have all their belongings with them when they leave the train? Thank you.
It's no use. He's just refusing to talk to us.
Don't worry. Here comes Inspector Wainwright. He's just done a training course in police negotiations.
Come on out now, Hinton. You have got a chance.
Have you ever been hit by a shower of fish? I haven't, but I know a bloke who was. About a year ago, I joined the SAS. Before that, I belonged to the Territorial Army, which is great as long as war's declared at the weekend or a bank holiday. The SAS have got the toughest training program in the world. You're trained to kill a man with just your little finger. You use it to pull the trigger on a Kalashnikov rifle. Now, about a year ago, I was leading this secret mission. Now, when we got to the airstrip, the commanding officer told us that we were a suicide squad, right? If it came to it, we had to kill ourselves rather than be captured by the enemy. My mate Bill didn't want to take any chances, so he hung himself before we got on the plane. They found him in the gent's toilet, swinging from the roller tail. Still, there was no time to stop for casualties. We just wiped our hands on him and got on the plane. Anyway, about 2 hours later, we're flying over a remote part of the British countryside when the order came to jump. Now, the most dangerous part of any parachute jump is the last 8 feet. That's why I always took a stepladder. Things went wrong right from the start. Some of us were blown miles off course.
Are safe, dear.
Look, I know how to put up a deck chair without it collapsing.
But despite these setbacks, I made my way to the agreed rendezvous.
I'm afraid I've got some rather bad news about Nugent.
So it's soft.
His stepladder didn't open.
What business was there? I'm soft.
Completely useless.
The first job of any fighting unit is to build a latrine. Pretty soon, our rations ran out, and it was up to me to catch breakfast for the rest of the men. But the men were still hungry, and in a desperate attempt to get some food, we caught a rabbit. Then we sent the rabbit down to the shops to get some pizzas. And so we set off on our mission. 3 days and three nights, we marched over open country, marching over mountains, marching under streams, from the Arctic Circle to the Sahara Desert. We marched and marched and marched. Until at last, it was time to open our sealed orders.
Don't march anywhere.
We were now only 300 yards from our target. But the problem was how to get past the security. It was then that I had an idea. Luckily, I'd remembered to pack the regimental paddling pool.
Good luck, sir.
Thank you.
And there, up in the window, was my target. It was now or never.
Stuck with his fish now. Does anybody want it?
I'll have it, mate.
You can have chips with that.
Not likely. This is my brother-in-law.
It could happen.